At Blue Sky Investing, we use incisive and methodical analysis to provide you with insights and perspective for your investing journey. Many of us woke up on May 12th and saw our stock portfolios sharply down. If you are a growth stock investor, your portfolio probably got hit harder. Here are some headlines. Stocks tumbled the most since February. Stocks jolted by inflation spike. Popular stocks like Etsy, Square, Fiverr, and Pinterest were all down anywhere between 4 to 6%. And if you look at the past 2 weeks, these stocks have been in a downward spiral. So what happened? Consumer price index data came out on May 12th and inflation numbers came out way more than expected. Inflation in April accelerated at its fastest pace in more than 12 years as the US economic recovery kicked into gear. The consumer price index, which measures the basket of goods as well as energy and housing costs, rose 4.2% from a year earlier. A Dow Jones survey had expected a 3.6% increase. The month-to-month gain was 0.8% against the expected 0.2%. The increase in the annual headline CPI rate was the fastest since September 2008, while the monthly gain in core inflation was the largest since 1981. So why did stocks sell off if inflation came in higher than expected? Runaway inflation can wreak havoc with an economy, causing prices of goods and services to spiral upward, putting strain on the citizens' spending power and quality of life. With higher inflation, every dollar would be worth less over time. Given that the US dollar is also a reserve currency across the world and the international trade happens in dollars, such fluctuations in how much the dollar is valued may make it less appealing to countries to use it as a reserve currency. Also, the popular market sentiment is that with increasing inflation, the Federal Reserve, the financial regulatory body in the US, may intervene and increase interest rates to prevent the economy from overheating. Why would the Fed increase interest rates? The Fed has a goal to keep inflation in check. Specifically, its goal is to keep inflation at an average of 2% over the next 3 years. Higher interest rates lead to decrease in lending activity. Lesser lending means less consumer credit, and which leads to less consumer spending. Less spending leads to decrease in consumer demand. With lower consumer demand, sellers adjust prices downward and prices thus lower and stabilize. Thus, inflation begins to trend downward when interest rates are raised, and this is a tool for the Fed to control runaway and sustained inflation. Additionally, popular belief in the stock market is that tightening interest rates are a signal for the end of a bull market. That is, stocks will no longer keep going up. Instead, they may enter a bear market and start trending down as consumer demand decreases and the economy may possibly enter a recession. So, should you sell all your stocks? Let us unpack this. What is causing this inflation spike? Current inflation numbers compare prices today to prices last year this time. Last year around this time, we were in a pandemic. Prices were low. With the low base to compare with, the inflation numbers today may look unreasonably high, but this comparison to the pandemic time prices is probably not the right comparison. With the economy reopening, people are itching to go out and spend. There is a lot of pent-up demand as people have been cooped up in their homes for a long time during the pandemic and are eager to go out, shop, eat, drink, travel and spend. Household financials are in great shape as people have been saving money over the lockdown and have not had too many avenues to spend. That was the demand side. Let us now look at the supply side. Supply chains have been disrupted by the pandemic. Lumber prices are skyrocketing. The Suez Canal blockage caused shipping rates to spike as the cost of one shipping container almost doubled. Countries in Southeast Asia, like India, that supply goods to the US have been hit hard by COVID, and exports to the US are either severely constrained, extremely expensive, or completely paused. It was recently reported that Apple's supply chain has been hit by the second wave of COVID in India. So what happens when you have high demand and low supply? An inflation spike. Let us understand this. Is this inflation spike long-lasting or transitory. The issues that are causing the supply chain shocks, are these long-lasting issues? Probably not. Over the next 2-3 quarters, as the economy reopens and life normalizes, most of the supply side shortages will be resolved. What does the Fed think? The Fed has stated multiple times so far that they believe that the inflation spike will be transitory and they expect inflation to trend back down and stabilize as the economy reopens and normalizes. The Fed has also stated explicitly that raising rates too soon will hurt a big chunk of the population that was impacted negatively by the pandemic. This would be the people who lost their jobs. And so the Fed plans to let inflation remain high for some time and will not intervene by raising interest rates. Now, could the Fed be lying and will they go ahead and raise interest rates regardless? Let us understand when the Fed typically raises interest rates in any standard economic cycle. In a standard economic cycle, there is growth and expansion followed by a peak. Typically, the Fed starts tightening interest rates when the economy overheats and market cycles seem to have hit a peak. As the higher interest rates take effect, the economy contracts and enter the recession, and this is then followed by a recovery and then another growth and expansion cycle kicks off. Right now we are just coming out of a pandemic induced recession, which means we are just entering a recovery phase. It doesn't make sense for the Fed to raise rates at this point in the economic cycle. Another factor that affects inflation is technology. Technology is a deflationary force. Amazon today allows you to buy goods at much cheaper prices and with a lot more optionality than when you were able to buy goods from a physical store only. Uber is bringing the cost of travel down for all via their technology-enabled ride-hailing services. Similarly, Airbnb has unlocked millions of unused housing inventory for travel-related lodging at very competitive prices and a ton of optionality to choose from. As technology and innovation thrive, prices generally tend to go down. Thus, technology acts as a deflationary force that thwarts inflation. Finally, let us take a look at history. Over the last 50 years, inflation has been in a downward spiral. Why would it go up all of a sudden in a sustained manner? Conclusion: inflation is most likely a transitory phenomenon as stated by the Fed and as seen by the rationale shared in this video. This means for any long-term investors with a 3-to-5-year horizon, days like today are great days to buy stocks. How should you prepare for the next 6 to 8 months? Shown here are the dates for the Consumer Price Index, CPI, or inflation readouts. Mark these dates on your calendars. The stock market, in anticipation of higher inflation numbers, will likely start trending down in the days leading up to these readout dates. Most economists and politicians are predicting that we will be back to normal life by September-October timeframe. This means that inflation should start to trend down by Q4 of this year, and so the inflation numbers will start to trend down in the readouts of October and November. Many will predict this and position their money into stocks in August and September, as the stock market typically adjusts in advance to future expectations. This means that May, June, and July may offer long-term investors some great dips in the stock market to buy stocks. If you are a long-term investor who regularly adds money to the stock market and has a 5 to 10 year horizon, none of this price volatility may actually mean much. Look at this 58-year chart of the S&P 500. If you bought along the way at regular intervals and held long enough, you would have made decent money. Remember, time in the market beats trying to time the market. This is not financial advice. Please consult a financial advisor for your investment decisions. If you like this content, please consider subscribing to my channel and please smash the like button and share this video with your friends and family. Thank you. And I wish you happy and safe investing.